My name's Leanne Hartman.
I am the nursing director for the CVICU units on Walter Tower 19 and 20 here at Houston Methodist Hospital.
My name is Nicholas Ellis. I've been a nurse here at Houston Methodist for 5 years.
I'm Elisa. I'm a nurse here. This is a cardiovascular, thoracic, and surgical unit.
My name is Daniel Steck. I'm a registered nurse here at Houston Methodist Walter Tower 20.
I'm Evelyn Cadillac. I'm an RN on Walter Tower 20 at Houston Methodist Hospital and Med Center.
My name is Alexis Telez. I'm a registered nurse, level 2, and we're on Walter Tower 20, Houston Methodist Hospital.
Walter Tower 20 is a 36-bed acute care cardiovascular step-down unit. What that means is either patients just had procedures. That could be a heart catheterization procedure. We take lung patients. We also take open heart surgery patients. If it's a major open heart surgery, the normal length of stay on our floor for heart surgery patients is about 5 to 6 days. If it is a transcatheter or a smaller interventional type of surgical procedure, it may be anywhere between 1 to 2 days.
Welcome to Walter 20. I'll be your nurse. I'm Elisa. I know, you gotta get used to all of us.
Nursing as a career is really a profession. It's not just touching somebody and being able to heal them. It's actually having a relationship with them.
What makes Walter 20 so special? It is the people who work in it and the patients who come through.
My team love each other. They see this as a second home. So when they come to work, they're in a good frame of mind. They're in good disposition, good spirits. That is kind of contagious.
When I come into work, I always know that somebody's gonna have my back. You know, if something goes south, someone's gonna be there. I always have somebody to rely on, whether it's my colleagues or leadership.
If you guys haven't noticed, nursing can be very difficult. You're under stress all the time, and sometimes it feels like you're drowning. Just the amount of support that I have from Nick and Leanne, it's incredible. You know, just I feel like every single day I have the opportunity to grow and learn.
Not every day is an easy day. In fact, most days are very difficult days. And so to know that we have coworkers that we can rely on, that we can talk to about not just our work life, but our home life.
They see each other as a family, and they really make sure that they provide an exceptional experience for the patient. We have layering of different levels of providers that help collaborate together as a team to develop treatment plans and processes for our patients. We have a CV surgery team that rounds on the patients every day. They're available 24 hours a day, as well as a nurse practitioner on the floor that stays available for any needs.
Being a physician assistant, I take care of patients before, during, and after surgery. I'm one of the first faces that they meet when they realize that they have to have cardiac surgery. I can perform a physical exam, interpret images, order labs and tests, as well as assist a surgeon in formulating a treatment plan.
Almighty and everlasting God, grant to this room the grace of your presence.
One of our chaplains, Martin, is exceptional. He has been with us for over a year or two now.
My role is to provide spiritual support for all our patients and family members.
Any patient that might be having a little bit of a difficult time and need encouragement, we go ahead and pull him in and ask him to come and see those patients to bond with them and connect with them. And then he does do follow-up visits every day while he's here.
I'm Angela. I'm one of the patient relations representatives here for Walter Tower 20. I actually have our lovely caring team volunteer, Isabel. This is the heart cart. What this consists of is customized heart pillows that we can deliver to our patients. We're already offering the red therapy heart pillow for our patients, so it's really nice that they can have something more personalized and a little bit smaller so they can take home as well.
We have so many pregnant people currently.
We have had lots of babies over the years. I feel like we shouldn't drink the water in the unit at this point because we're having so many babies.
Today we had a team baby shower to celebrate one of our team members, one of our nurses, Perla.
Whether it's babies, whether it's retirement, whether it's people graduating from school, they really just take that time to really recognize that person. And I think that is why we are as successful as we are and why we have as good outcomes as we do on the units.